Damn, man, this motherfucker on this team whooping this boy ass. Man, I'm telling you, it's a good ass fight, man. It's like Kane beating your ass the other night, man.
Yeah, nigga. I bet you Kane won't be laughing after Bob won't get a hold of this motherfucker.
You know what I'm
saying? Bet that shit.
A new day brings a new problem to a brother, and all I got to say is thank God I'm of a mother. Cause without my mommy, dear, my life would have been a joke. Either locked up, laying dead, or stealing dope and dope. But nope, the Lord, he had a plan for me, and with his help, my mother man of me. Didn't blindfold me to the world we was living in. Taught me how to save my dividend. When I graduated, I'd have a little school money. But in the sixth grade, I wanted to school. And flunked out of school with the flagpole. And mother at home sad so. Because my mother worked the fingers to the bone. Cause we was alone. And me up F home. My real pops, he broke out with the style. So I respect my stepdad for raising another nigga's child. So now we living comfortable. Taught me the game and how to sponsor. But back then I couldn't see it. I wanted to be a grown man at 14, kids, and ended up in a big fight. And told me not to come home until I shit my shit right. So now I'm living at my grandma's home. My grandma's got Isabel on. And keeping me ain't no big deal. But now that I'm much older, I see just shit feels. Being kind-hearted, not wanting to tell me no. Even though my grandpa's had a stroke. And now the money's low. And pretty soon, a brother have to either try to find a job so I can help out. I'm in the ghetto, I got to self out. And when I get out, I gotta try to pave the way so my family can have a place to stay. I'm losing all hope, a brother's falling short. I can't cope, so now I'm slanging dope. And now my granny knows I'm doing wrong. She just praying for me heavily, take his grandson. And the Lord must have heard up prayer, cause he made me get a grip. Got me out of there. I heard my mother say them streets is gonna kill you. You couldn't have told me nothing back then, but nothing feel you. Now I'm 22 and finally got a grip on life. It's 1993, I put away my pocket knife and got a bigger stick to fight with. I'm young and black, so my choice ain't a nice pick. Because we living in a concentration set, and every day we face to face with death. I've seen my homies go and come, and judgment day is just something we can't run from. So I know my number's coming up, so I gotta protect myself from suckers running up. And even though I hate killing off my own kind, I gotta be a man, and as a man I've been. My brother Corn is trying to keep the neighborhood at peace. Don't fight each other, we got to stand and fight the beast. So united we stand, but we gon' fall quick, because we always trying to take another shit. And the cops is in the same boat. Just because we coming up quick, they slang dope. They shooting and kill, they gas ain't sparking dud. They shot my long time partner cold blood. And now the story's all twisted up. And if they gave the cop the chair, I really give a fuck. Because you left my partner's family with memories. And after hearing this, I know you remember me. But yet and still I find it hard for me to stay in touch. I see his parents and then I'm breaking up. Because I know what you did was wrong, but you won't realize until dead and gone. It ain't no justifiable homicide. You never gave a warning, you straight up from behind. But all the crying in the world ain't gonna bring him back. You give a gat to a black who how to act. But you gotta tell your story to the judge, not the imitation judge. The judge that bodies. And if the man upstairs grants you forgiveness, then in reality you took his business. But regardless, I know you wanna kill me, but I ain't going out like that. Feel me, feel me.
If this was your TV, you got your ass whooped. I don't give a fuck what you're talking about.